Hi guys, and welcome back in Medical Scribe. In this video, we will talk about the dermis from an anatomical point of view. In the previous video, we say that the skin is composed of two layers, the epidermis, which is the superficial layer, and the dermis, which is the deep layer that's found under the epidermis. And we will explain the dermis layer today. The dermis layer is a connective tissue that's mainly work to support the epidermis layer. So this layer will consist of dense irregular connective tissue and areolar connective tissue. That's represented mainly by the existence of collagen and elastin fibers. This collagen and elastin will be arranged as bundles, and these bundles will run in all directions. So they will interlace, making woven or tissue-like pattern. And if we classify the dermis layer structurally, it will be divided into two layers, which are the papillary dermis and the reticular layer. The papillary dermis is the superficial layer in the dermis, which are finger-like projections, while the reticular layer is the layer that's found under the papillary dermis, which will compose, as we said, from dense irregular connective tissue. And the basal layer of the dermis will be attached to the deep fascia, or attached to the bone, by the superficial fascia. That means, firstly we will have the epidermis, then we will find the dermis layer, after that, the superficial fascia, then the deep structures, like the deep fascia, or the muscles, or the bones. Alright. The dermis will look like the epidermis in a way that are not of one thickness, because generally, the dermis of the anterior surfaces of the body will be thinner than the dermis of the posterior surfaces of the body. And also, in women, it will be thinner than that of men. Okay. Lastly, we have to know the functions of this layer. The dermis layer has four main functions, which are the skin elasticity, so it will allow skin stretching and give it flexibility because of collagen fibers. Secondly, it will make the skin resist the wrinkles and sagging that occurs to it because of the elastin. And at the same time, it will give the skin the strength and toughness also because of the elastin. And finally, the dermis will be the terminal site of the blood vessels and lymphatics and the sensory nerves where they will end. And it will consider as the site of origin or site from where the hair roots and the glands arise. So those were generally the dermis functions. So that was almost everything about the dermis layer. And that's it. I hope what I said makes sense. See you next video. And goodbye.